Very good evening to all of you all. Welcome to the session on monthly return GSTR 3B in Tally ERP 9 Release 6. Let us look at the GSTR Form 3B returns filing dates. For the month of July, filing date is due on 25th August or 28th August, and for the August month, the due date is 20th September. For July month, businesses who do not want to avail transitional credit, that is the input tax credit, from pre-GST regime to reduce your tax liability of July, the last date for payment of tax and filing 3B will be 25th August. Businesses who want to use transitional credit to reduce your July tax liability, the last date for filing 3B will be 20th August. In this case, you need to calculate tax payable, that is equal to output tax liability plus tax payable under reverse charge, less transitional credit, less input tax credit for the month of July, and pay the tax by 25th of August. File TRAN 1 in GSTN portal by 28th August, but before filing GSTR 3B. Prepare and file GSTR 3B by or before 20th August 2017. If any shortfall of tax paid, pay the amount with interest at the rate 18% from 26th August 2017 till the date of such payment. So let us know how you get your books ready for GSTR Form 3B filing. Ensure GST rates and party GSTN is configured. Ensure all your GST sales and GST purchases, that is GSTR 1 and GSTR 2, is complete. Tax liability for reverse charge mechanism transactions and advances received are accounted. Eligible input tax credits are accounted, which may also include transitional credit, that is the opening balance, input tax credit availed in current regime and reflecting in your last return, that could be SenVAT credit, VAT input tax credit, or availing tax credit on closing stock dated 30th June 2017 through TRAN 1. Ensure that no incomplete mismatch in your GSTR reports. These are the potential exceptions which requires correction before you make the data ready for filing your GSTR 3B. These errors are listed on priority. The exceptions could be like you have not selected the country, state and dealer type, and tax rates you are not specified, and the nature of transaction not updated, and could be incorrect tax ledgers selected during the transactions. So these are highlighted to you when you try to generate your Form 3B as an exceptions, and you have to just drill down to these exceptions and resolve them. Let us look at the procedure for filing GSTR return Form 3B. GSTR returns report. GSTR 3B summary of GSTR 1 and GSTR 2 is made available in the table wise view as prescribed by GSTN. Clear the exceptions if any. Print return form 3B into Word doc. As we all know, GSTN has not provided any offline utility, nor there is a provision to do direct uploading of GSTR 3B returns. So take a print from Tally, log into GSTN portal, fill the values as printed against each table. GST tax liability is auto-populated from e-liability ledger. Set off GST liability if sufficient GST ITC is available. If not, generate challan, pay the tax liability if any, and file GSTR 3B returns. Later, do the book entries for eligible GST input tax credit adjusted with GST liability and GST liability payment entry if any. So now we will navigate to the product and see how GSTR 3B can be looked at table wise as prescribed by GSTN portal, and how this can be printed and made available readily to update those values in the GST portal against Form 3B. So we will move on to the product release 6.0.3, which is in market, where we have supported Form 3B. So here is Krishna Interiors Company. running their business in Uttarakhand, and they are ready with their data of all their GST sales and purchases for the month of July and are now going to file their GSTR 3B. And let us see how this GSTR 3B is being structured in Tally in line with your GSTN portal. So from Gateway of Tally, display statutory reports, GST, GSTR 3B. So this is the structure table number wise, starting from 3.1. 1 and 2 is about your GSTN number and the party who's filing. 3.1 talks about outward supplies and inward supplies liable to reverse charge. Let us enter into detail mode. So here are again the sections A to E showing the complete details of values being captured. A says about outward taxable supplies other than zero rated, nil rated and exempted. B, outward taxable supplies which are of zero rated. It may also have your exports where you would have not charged tax. Other than outward supplies, nil rated, exempted are captured here. And D, inward supplies liable to reverse charge. So all the transactions accounted through GST purchases which are marked for reverse charge and the liability is raised are getting captured here. Non-GST outward supplies, all the goods which do not form part of GST compliance are sold out. They come under this. And 3.2 says about the GST sales done to the interstate parties who are unregistered, composition taxable person and UIN holders. UIN holders are the government entity. Let us get into detail mode. So here the transaction is accounted against unregistered person, composition and UIN holders are captured here. So table 4 talks about eligible ITC. So all the eligible input tax credits accounted during the period is captured here. Let us enter into detail mode. So eligible ITC is further divided into A, B, C, D. So let us navigate them and understand what values are captured here. ITC available whether in full or partial. So all the eligible input tax credits that is accounted as claiming input tax credit, it could be on imports of goods where the recipient would have paid the liability and now claiming input tax credit, imports of services and inward supply is liable to reverse charge. So where you would have accounted all the services or goods forming part of reverse charge, paid the liability and now claiming input tax credits are captured here. Inward supplies from input service distributors where the credit amount is transferred between the branches and eligible for input tax credits, and all other ITC that is claimable on GST purchases is captured here. Section B talks about ITC reversed as per rule 42 and 43 of CGST rules, where you would have claimed ITC wrongly. For example, exempted purchases are accounted as taxable purchases, so you are supposed to reverse the input tax credit. So it is done through the relevant journal adjustment entry, selecting the nature of adjustments as reversal of input tax credit. So here comes section C showing the net ITC available, which is A minus B. And D says about ineligible ITC. So all those nature of transactions where you have marked for ineligible ITC and a certain transaction where you were not eligible and you have claimed ITC, you have to reverse them marking as ineligible input tax credit as per section 17 subsection 5. And table 5 talks about value of exempt, nil rated and non-GST inward supplies, that is all the GST purchases done with this nature. Let us drill down and see. This is the purchases done from the suppliers who are composite scheme, exempt and nil rated supply. Can drill down to the vouchers forming part of this nature. So all exempted, nil rated forms part here, composition tax suppliers and non-GST supply. All the goods bought in which are of non-GST goods could be local or interstate gets captured here. So this is all about the complete structured table-wise information as defined by GSTN portal, which is available. So the next step is clear if any exceptions are there. As we informed, incomplete mismatch in information to be resolved must be zero. There should not be any exceptions. So if there are exceptions, it should form part, as they are to be included in your returns, you have to clear the exceptions. So the next step is, now the data is complete, GSTR 3B data is complete. You have to just take a print of this. Print return, GSTR 3B for July is getting printed. You can see the print details, it is similar to what is provided in the portal. Capturing about year and month for which we are doing, 1 and 2 talks about GSTN. And the person responsible for filing the returns, and then the table wise information 3.1, 3.2 and 4 talks about eligible ITC, 5 all the purchases of this nature, and very important 6.1 payment of tax, tax payable, integrated tax, central tax, state tax gets updated automatically based on your above table values being filled. So paid through ITC has to be entered to offset your liability if you have any eligible input tax credit. And you can see there are certain instructions stated by the department. Based on these instructions, the values are aptly captured in Form 3B. So we have taken a printout. Now the step is to log on to the GSTN portal with your login credentials. Go to monthly return form GSTR 3B. Prepare online, enter all these values and proceed. So let us see the other steps. So GSTR 3B print from Tally RP9, which we did. This will be helpful to refer while entering the values in GSTN portal. So the navigation is from Gateway of Tally Display, Statutory Reports, GST Reports, GSTR 3B and Print Return. So this is the print of view of GSTR 3B and the print view of GSTR 3B. So here we are demonstrating with the simple values so that it will be easy to relate. So what is the next step? So we did with these steps. Log into GSTN portal. Log into GSTN portal to do GSTR 3B online filing. So let us move on to GSTN portal to show how the values are entered. Select the site gst.gov.in, click on login, give the captcha here, click on login. So we have logged in. So what is the next step? This login we have done. So the next step is go to services, returns, return dashboard, select the return filing period and click search. So go to services, returns, return dashboard, or directly return dashboard here. Click on return dashboard, select the period for July, click on search. So here are the forms to be updated for your July month, GST1, 2A and 3B. So here is monthly return GSTR 3B. Under monthly return GSTR 3B, click prepare online. So you get an option here, prepare online. So this is the screen we navigated. Select the relevant table number and enter necessary details in each box. So let us drill down to this and see how the values are already entered here. This is the submitted information shown here. So here, if you see, the values are entered here. Tax table 1, 3.1, 3.2, 4 eligible ITC. The amount is entered here. You can see the values. And here, as we said, the payment of tax shows the complete liability as shown, that is the first section 3.1, which will be captured in your e-liability ledger, and same as shown here. So you have to further drill down to this and enter your eligible ITCs to reduce your GST liability. So we will see this. Select relevant table and enter necessary details. So the moment you drill down to the table, this is the screen you get, and fill in the values and confirm. Now verify the GSTR 3B tables. Note table number 6, payment of tax will capture entire GST liability as depicted in e-liability ledger. Tick the checkbox and enter on table number 6 to set off the liability with available GST ITC if any. So we will move on to the portal. So once you checked all the details in the tables, there is a tick box here. Tick this box and drill down to payment of tax. So here you can see the details. As we said, auto populates the tax payable amount here, giving the tax breakups of GST taxes. And here, paid through ITC, you are supposed to see what is the balance available for ITC. So central tax is 51,418 and also state tax you have 51,480. So here is an option to click on set off liability. In case here you can see there is an integrated tax liability as well. So you get a message that a balance, cash balance is insufficient because you have a liability of 2232 where you don't have any credit of this. So first you have to make the payment and then come back here and give the set off values here so that it gets set off. So e-cash balance must be updated. So how do we do that? So in case you have enough ITC here, straight away click on offset liability, it gets offset and the net liability payable to department will be updated accordingly. So we tick the checkbox and entered on table number 6 to set off the liability with available ITC. This was the screen. And then if no sufficient credit amount to adjust, as we said, you have to create challan for GST liability, make payment and e-cash balance will get updated. You can set off GST liability. So how do we do this? So go back again, services. So here we have the provision to generate challan payment. You are supposed to do the payment. That is, you have to create a challan. Click on create challan. So you have to enter the values of the liability amount, the GST tax liability in the GST tax breakup wise, CGST, IGST, CESS, and SGST. So as we said here, the procedure of generating challan to make GST payment, go to services, payment, create challan. First fill tax breakup in respective cells in challan, select required payment mode. So how do we get the payment mode? You can scroll down after entering the values. So here is the payment modes, e-payment, over the counter, NEFT, RTGS, and click on generate challan after selecting. So here we have shown the demonstrated values. So how to enter the values, and same will be shown in tally product as well. Okay, after the challan is done, what is the next step? Challan is generated as below. Details of depositing, how much liability it has to be deposited. Here it shows about the GST account to which you have to make the payment. Make the payment to GST account specified in the challan, then the e-cash ledger balance will get updated. Now set off GST liability in box 6 payment of tax and file your GSTR 3B returns. So we were talking about the ledgers, so let us look at the ledger. So this was about the challan. And now how do we know the balances of my ledgers? So here are the ledgers. Electronic liability ledger, that is the entire liability which you have accounted entered in 3.1, and then eligible ITC. Electronic credit ledger shows the eligible ITC. It could also have your transitional credit amount being credited to your account based on the validation by the department, and electronic cash ledger. So the moment you do the liability payment, the cash ledger gets updated here. Go back to the payment section 6.1 and offset your liability so that your net liable amount will be reflected. So these are the ledgers. So what is the next step? Book entries in Tally RP9 after GSTR 3B filing is done. So let us say the update of GSTR return filing here is done. The returns form 3B returns dashboard, and you have clicked on file GSTR 3B once the payment is done. So the balance liability will be reflected with a net liability in the box 6.1 payment of tax. So now, as we were talking about transitional credits, those who want to avail, they have to click here transition forms. We have two forms updated here, like for manufacturers and dealers, and accordingly you can calculate your tax liability. So this has to be updated so that you'll be able to make the tax payment by 25th August. So this is how we navigate through the GSTN portal and file your GSTR 3B successfully. So now we will look at what needs to be done in books of accounts. As you have done the set off of GST liability with GST ITC in the GSTN portal under payment of tax details, and also GST liability payment, which you have generated a challan, took a printout, and you would have made a payment through modes, could be NEFT, RTGS, and now you are supposed to account them in your books of accounts to match the transactions. So journal entry as nature of adjustment to decrease of tax liability with additional details, adjustment against credit. So here you're supposed to debit all your GST taxes holding credit balances and credit your GST taxes holding debit balances with which you are reducing your GST tax liability. Later, make a payment entry as stat payment to account the GST liability paid to GST through relevant modes of payment. This will be shown in GST reports challan reconciliation. So now, keeping example of these simple values as demonstrated in the presentation, we will move on to tally release 6.0.3 and see how the adjustment entry and the payment is made. So we will load the company having a similar values. So you can see here national status, same thing demonstrated, GSTR 3B for July month, having a liability of 2 lakhs and input tax credit of 1 lakh, central tax, state tax, and there is an integrated tax of 2,232. So now my ITC of 1 lakh to 2,000 change how to be adjusted with liability. So click on stat adjustments. What are we doing? Nature of adjustments, decrease of tax liability. With what are you doing? Additional details, adjustment against credit. Now you will be debiting your GST tax ledgers which will have a credit balance. Let us take central tax. You can give the rate and taxable value. It is holding a credit of 1,01,000 and we have a, it is holding a liability balance. Now as we have seen in the values, we have central tax 51,000 change, so let us account them 51,417, or a separate ledger in case you have created, not an issue. So with common ledgers you can have the balances knocked off. So as we all know, central tax ITC can be first adjusted with central tax liability, state tax with state tax, integrated tax, integrated tax. So here central tax liability with central tax input, and then state tax liability with state tax input, where the entire debit amount is utilized. So now you can see here the still liability ledgers are holding the credit amount 49 and 49, which comes to 1 lakh, which you are supposed to remit to the department. So this is the journal adjustment entry setting of your GST ITC with GST liability, and then we will do a payment entry. Accounting vouchers, payment, stat payment, GST for the month of July. It is a regular payment. Let us see if you are doing on 1st of August. And select the bank account through which you are remitting the GST liability. Let us select the GST taxes holding credit balances, which is a liability. We have here in this data integrated tax of 2232 and central tax of 4973 and state tax of 49. And this is after knocking off your with ITC. So you have seen all the liability ledgers be knocked off. So here we have provide GST details. Click on S. These are the modes of payment through which you will be remitting GST liability. As a department also stated these modes, you can accordingly select here. So NEFT, RTG, you can whatever mode you have selected, you can select here, and there is a norms more than 10,000 you're supposed to do e-payments. So let us select NEFT, RTG here, the bank name, the CPIN number, the CIN number, UTR number, and the date of payment done. So the moment you key in these details, it forms part of your challan reconciliation. And you can see here the liability of 101692 is accounted as payment, whatever mode of payment is done. So save this, and we will navigate to challan reconciliation. From Gateway of Tally, display statutory reports, GST, GST challan. So the entry of payment, stat payment done for 101692 is captured here. So this is about the book entries of your GSTR 3B details. So we do have help articles updated in help.tallysolutions.com. So please do refer help.tallysolutions.com. Thank you.